Hello, class. How are you? Hope you are well and safe. And today I'm going to give you an overview of Chapter 7, which is Accessing Organizational Information Data Warehouse. So, in our last chapter, we have learned about the term database, and in this chapter, what we are going to understand the role and the purpose of the data warehouse and the difference between the data warehouse and the data marts in an organization. Also, to get an understanding of the business intelligence to support the managerial decision-making process. So, in terms of understanding the data warehouse, what is a data warehouse? So, just to give you a brief understanding of the history, is in the 1990s, as organizations began to need more timely information about their business, they found that traditional management information systems was too overwhelming, especially to provide relevant information efficiently and effectively. And most of these systems were in the form of operational database that were designed to, especially for specific business functions such as accounting, order entry, customer service, sales, and were not really appropriate for business analysis for that particular reasons. So what happened in the later half of the 20th century, the number of types of operational database increased, and many large organizations found themselves with information scattered across multiple systems with different file types, such as the spreadsheets, database, Word file, and making it almost impossible for anyone to use information from multiple sources. So completing a report, especially reporting request across operational systems, could take days or weeks using antiquated reporting tools that were ineffective for running the business. And for this reason, the idea, the data warehouse was born as a place where relevant information could be stored and accessed for making the strategic inquiries and reports. So the term data warehouse is the logical collection of information gathered from many different operational databases. When I say operational database, it could be from the accounting division, from the HR divisions, from anywhere within the organizations. And this supports the business analysis activities and decision-making tasks. So the primary purpose is to aggregate, meaning collect information throughout an organization into a single repository decision-making purpose. What do we mean by repository? Which is the central location in which data is stored and managed. In terms of understanding the data warehousing, the reasons business analysis is difficult from operational database could be for several reasons, but let me just go over a few of them. The inconsistent data definitions, lack of data standards, poor quality data, inadequate data usefulness, and ineffective data across, data access. Okay, so to the key idea within the data warehousing is to collect information from multiple systems. And this allows the operational database to run where they are most efficient for the business while providing common locations. And the data warehouse go even further steps by standardizing information. So let's say for gender, in a way that the male and female, it could be standardized as M/F or 1/0. But it should be standardized in a data warehouse with some common way of referring to each data element that stores gender. So standardization is one advantage of data elements, which allows for greater accuracy, completeness, and consistency, and increases the quality of information in making the strategic business decisions. The data warehouse then is simply a tool that enable business users, typically leaders in the organizations, managers, store supervisors, to be more effective in many ways, including developing customer profiles, identifying new product opportunities, improving the business operations, analyzing the financial issues, identifying the financial issues, analyzing trends, understanding competitors, and understanding the product performance. So the important part of this data warehouse is it has three components, which is data marts, information cleansing, and business intelligence. For the data marts, it's very important for you to understand the data aggregation. The data aggregation is a collection of data from various sources for the purpose of data processing. And one of the examples of data aggregation is to gather information about particular groups based on specific variables such as age, profession, income, and so on. And organizations collect tremendous amount of transactional information as part of their routine operations. Marketing, sales, and other departments, they can also analyze these data to understand their operations better. So the data warehouse modeled, which includes information from internal database or transactional operational database and even external database through the process called extraction, transformation, and loading, ETL. It's just ensuring the process that extracts information from internal and external database, then it transforms information using a common set of enterprise definition, and finally it loads the information into the data warehouse. Then the data warehouse sends subsets of information to the data marts. What is the function of data marts? It contains and includes a subset of data warehouse information. And to even distinguish between the data warehouse and data marts, think about that data warehouse is having a more organizational focus, and data marts is having focused information subsets particular to the needs of given business units, such as finance, production, sales, operations, HR. So it's kind of focusing on one narrow given business unit. Okay, going to the next slide, which gives you an example of how the data marts. These are the examples of data marts. This is the data warehouse. As you can see, it's getting the information from multiple operational data warehouse, and then it goes through the ETL process, extraction, transformation, and loading. And from the internal database and the external database, again, it goes through the ETL process and feeds the information in the data warehouse. The organization, of course, they have to maintain high quality information. And in order to maintain the high quality information, they have to work on whether the data is accurate, consistent, complete. And for that purpose, sometimes it's important to make sure that the organizations have to go through the information cleansing and scrubbing, which is the process that weeds out and fixes or discards any inconsistency, incorrect, or incomplete information. So just having the data itself is not really ensuring the process. So you have to make sure that through the cleansing and scrubbing process, the data is accurate, consistent, and complete. There are specialized software tools which can be used to analyze, standardize, correct, match, and consolidate the data warehouse information. And in the data warehouse, information cleansing occurs first during the ETL process, and again once information is in the data warehouse. So organizations choose information cleansing software from several vendors. Could be from Oracle, SAS, Accenture software, Group One software, and you know, they are usually they scrub the information and making sure the information is accurate and consistent. Coming to the next slide. Okay. So one of the achievements that the organizations want is they want to see that their information should be somewhere in this quadrant. But again, it's very costly because none organization can give you that assurance that their information is 100% complete and 100% accurate. So achieving perfect information is almost impossible. The more complete and accurate an organization wants its information to be, the more it costs. But the trade-off is that information lies in accuracy versus completeness. Accurate information means it is It is correct, while complete information means there are no blanks. So, in other words, for the most organizations to determine a percentage high enough to make good decisions at a reasonable cost, such as 85% accurate and 65% complete. The third component of the data warehouse component is to understand the business intelligence. Now, organizations today find it the next to like, impossible to understand their own strengths and weakness. And at one point, the data point, which is an individual item on a graph or a chart, organizational data includes far more than simple structured data elements in a database. So an early reference to business intelligence occurs in the book titled The Art of War. And the author claimed that to succeed in war, one should have full knowledge of one's own strength and weakness and full knowledge of the enemy's strength and weakness. Lacking of either one might result in defeat. So a certain school of thought draws parallel between the challenges in business and those of war, specifically collecting information, discerning patterns and meaning in the information, responding to the resultant information. So a business started automating more and more systems, and more information become available. However, collection remained a challenge due to lack of infrastructure for information exchange or to incompatibilities between systems. So reporting sometimes took months to generate, and such reports allowed information long-term strategic decision making. However, short-term tactical decisions making continued to rely on intuition. And in modern business, increasing standards, automation, technologies have led to vast amounts of information available. So the ideal business scenario would be as follows. Business manager would be able to meet with the clients, reviews historical customer data. Then he realizes that the client's ordering the volume has substantially decreased. And then he would be able to drill down into the data and then notice that the client had a support issue with the particular product. He quickly then calls the support teams to find out the information and learns that the replacement for defective part can be shipped in 24 hours. So this is handy only if, because the rich data information is available. And for that, organizational data contains that unstructured, such as voice, mail, phone calls, text messages, and the organizational data also contains the structured data in the database. So that's why it's difficult sometimes to really manipulate the large amount of data generated in because it's doubling every year. So improving the quality of business decisions has a direct impact on cost and revenue. And business intelligence enable the business users to receive the data for analysis that is reliable, consistent, understandable, as well as easily manipulated. A few examples of how different industries use business intelligence include in the, let's say, in the banking industry, understanding customer credit card usage and non-payment rates. In the healthcare industry, comparing the demographics of patients with critical illnesses. Marketing, analyzing the customer demographics. In the technology, predicting hardware failures. So it's really business intelligence can find the cause to many issues and problems simply by asking why. And the process starts by analyzing the report, such as sales amounts by quarter. Then the manager can drill down into the report, looking for why sales are up and why sales are down. Once they understand why a certain locations or product is experiencing an increase in sales and why decrease, they can then share the information in an effort to raise enterprise-wide sales. So, in other words, business intelligence can help managers with competitive monitoring, where a company keeps tabs on its competitors' activities on the web using software that automatically tracks all competitors' websites' activities, such as discounts and new products. And so pretty much that's all about it, class, for this particular chapter. I'm just going to quickly give you an review. What we have covered, a brief history on the data warehouse. The term, what is the data warehouse, and the three components that includes the data marts, and the cleansing and scrubbing, and finally the business intelligence, which is the last one. Okay, so that's all about it. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to contact me, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.